Welcome to the ET-335 7447 lab presentation.
Hello, here's the lecture presentation on the 744 BCD to 7 segment LED. BCD means binary coded decimal. We're going to use a 4-bit number from 0 to 9, and this device is going to decode it and display on the 7 segment. Here's our limiting resistors here, current limiting resistors, and a bank. And here's our input switches that binary weighted 0, 2, 4, 8. And right now we have a 0 in. When I open this switch, we get a 1. Okay. When I open up B, we get a 2. Open up both, we get 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Here's our 7447 BCD to 7 segment LED decoder connected to our 7 segment in the light test mode. Okay, so if we tie pin 3 light test, LT means light test, we will test all the LED segments in our display and we should get an A. It'll ignore all inputs and just display the 8. Here's the 7447 tied into the blanking input. We see that pin 4 is tied low, and that will give us a blanking input, which means that all the LED segments are off, and it'll ignore all the inputs, and it'll blank it out. Here we show our 7490 BCD counter connected to our decoder through our resistor to our display. What we have here is our master set. Here we have pin 6 and 7 tied high, which is going to make a master set, which is going to output a 9 and ignore all the other inputs. Here's our count display circuit, and what we've done here is we have a master reset. We've tied our pins 2 and 3 high, so our master reset NAND gate gets triggered, and we display a 0. So the master reset would display a 0 and ignore all the inputs. Here we have the 7490 driving the 7447. This one's set up in the BCD mode. This one's on decoding it. All the master sets and resets are in the position where they'll operate normally. And when we turn it on, we are getting a count of 0 to 9. Here we have two cascaded 7490 into 7447. The lower one is going to be the least significant digit, and this top one's going to be the most significant digit. What we've done is we've allowed this one to count from 0 to 9, and then we've taken the output off of QD and we fed it into the clock of the second counter, and it'll multiply everything by 10. So we're going to get a count of 0 through 99.